Hello and welcome to Nirmal Bang, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Hiral Daria. We have with us Ramesh Kalyan Raman, Executive Director at Kalyan Jewelers, joining in. Welcome to the show, Ramesh. A pleasure to speak to you as always. My first question coming to you is, the industry as a whole in which you operate, a lot of pressures that have come in on the back of COVID. There have been ups and downs. Overall, yes, we understand that the quarter did suffer. However, you've again seen daylight with the momentum picking up in the month of June, July, and August.
Yeah.
Could you explain to us as to, you know, overall, how has the entire experience been so far?
So first of all, let me start by saying that we are happy with the outcome of Q1. We are a consumer-facing brand, and when the pandemic is hit and when the stores are getting closed, we'll be affected. We'll be the first to get affected. But why we are happy with the outcome is that the momentum which we saw when the stores were open, it is very strong. So if you look at the comeback of the customers inside the store post the second wave, has been very, very strong. And we have seen a clear shift from unorganized to organized. We have seen at least more than 50% of 50% growth in the new customers walk in, a clear shift from unorganized to organized. And if you look at our June, even with only 52% of the showrooms open, we are very close to the previous year revenue. And if you look at our SSG in June, normalized for working days, when compared to the last financial year, it is 68%. So that is the kind of momentum which we see. And we still feel that momentum continuing in July and August. The gross margins are almost stabilized. So that is why we are happy with the outcome.
Right. So overall, Ramesh, the losses have narrowed as well. And we've seen a sustained recovery, you know, with the losses narrowing. Do you think FY22, we will be able to break even?
Yeah, but if you look at Q1, we are already like 109% achievement we have in terms of revenue. The losses are narrowed down. Even in the last financial year, Q3 was a very good quarter. Q4 was a very good quarter. The year ended up in a deficit only because of the Q1 and Q2.
Correct.
Really was hurt last time, because last time Q1 was almost a lockdown, and Q2 the recovery was much slower than what is happening now. Now people know to live with it, and that we see in the stores, the momentum which we see, the growth which we see is almost similar to the Q4 levels. So we don't see any ambiguity unless and until again the stores gets closed.
Right. And overall, Ramesh, firstly, most of the stores were shut in May. I think only 52 were operational in the month of June. And in the month of August, now you have all showrooms which are open on weekdays. Now, taking this scenario into consideration, how are you anticipating the first quarter of FY22? Do you think it will be slightly muted on overall numbers? But then the remaining three quarters is something that will be strong, taking into consideration that you have the wedding season, you know, the festive season that kicks in.
Yeah, so this year, the highlight is that Q2, now when we speak, all the stores are open. And momentum is very high. So when you compare with the previous financial year, this was not the scenario. Q1 was very, very bad. And even with all that, we had a PAT of, 150 crore in the last financial year for India. Okay, so this year, all the stores are open, momentum is very high, gross profit is almost stabilized, and the wedding season is coming in the in Kerala, in South India. Now the wedding season starts for Onam in Kerala. And you know, Q3 is a wedding season almost everywhere except Kerala. So, and the momentum is also very positive. So we are awaiting for the season to come.
Right. And with all of this right now, overall, if you have to see the e-commerce division, I know it's still a small portion of overall revenues, but the kind of growth that it has seen recently, it's fabulous up move. Now, do you think that's something which you would want to focus on?
So e-commerce is doing very well.
Correct.
It has seen a 3.5x growth when compared to the previous financial year. Even if you compare with FY 2020, there is almost a 2x growth. So it has been growing over the past many years. We are constantly focusing on our e-commerce as well. But of course, it is never a substitute for our offline stores. Those segment of customers or the purpose of buying, etc., are different from what is happening offline. But yes, as a segment, it is really growing.
Right. So will we concentrate on e-commerce, do you think? I'm sure it can't become as large as the revenue that you get from the physical outlets. But over time, how much do you think you want to grow it to and invest on that side of the business?
Now, we are constantly innovating, investing in e-commerce for the past 3-4 years.
Correct.
After we acquired Candier online portal. And the revenue has been doubling almost every year. So there is constant focus on it. There is constant investment which goes, and that will continue. But as I told you, offline is also growing with it. So as a percentage, maybe it is going to be constant. But when we open new stores, for example, this year, already we opened 9 new showrooms in Q1. So the revenue base in our offline will also, what you call, grow. And online also grows. As a percentage, there might not be any difference. But online, yes, it is growing. And as I told you, it has grown 3.5x times when compared to the previous financial year Q1.
Right. And how is the Middle East business doing? What's the scenario looking like on that side as well?
So Middle East, we saw a good recovery in Q4 and Q3 of last financial year. When this financial year opened April, a couple of weeks, that was the same scenario. But as you know, Indians are our base customers there. More than 90% of our customers are Indians in Middle East as well. We cater them. So Indians usually shop when they come back to their country. So when the flight connectivity gets hampered because of the COVID-19 second wave in India, that really affect the sentiment of customers there. And we saw that the momentum has was a bit cold for the rest of the quarter. So as of now, it is picking up, but it is not reached to the Q4 levels, because even now, you know that there is a issue in flight connectivity, etc.
Right. And how is the gold savings scheme doing across the industry right now? Because, you know, we did see some bit of a slump that did come in. A lot of new enrollments have not happened on the back of COVID. But are you seeing a pickup on the gold investment savings scheme as well?
No, enrollment has been very healthy even in Q1. It actually grew by 30%. But why the gold scheme revenue contribution in this quarter was lesser is because last year in the same quarter, there was no enrollments because of lockdown. So usually it the customers remit for 11 months and shop at the end of the 12th month. So when your enrollment is very low in Q1 of the last financial year, the revenue because of gold savings scheme will be lesser in this Q1. That is why the revenue contribution was lesser. Enrollments are seeing a spike. It is grown by around 30%.
Okay. And overall, in terms of our new store opening plans go, do you think taking COVID into consideration, we will somewhere remain status quo? Or do we think we will be really aggressive with regards to store openings in the current financial year as well?
No, our plan for this financial year was to open 21 new showrooms in India, out of which 9 we have already done in Q1. And the rest of the showrooms, as per today's estimate, should be completed in this financial year, and it will be as per our plan.
Okay. And in terms of revenue contribution between the southern and the non-southern markets, what is the kind of contribution we are seeing? And is there going to be more focus to grow the non-southern markets, because we are already really strong in the south?
Yeah, so south, out of the 9 showrooms which we opened, 8 was in South India.
Correct.
So South India is a major market for us, and we don't want to leave out the positioning in South. So we will be expanding in South, but of course, the rest of the showrooms, the focus is to open more in non-South areas. And the revenue contribution, if you ask, our usual revenue ratio is 65% in South India and 35% outside South India. But if you look at our Q1, it is 70% South and 30% outside South. And that was majorly because in the month of April, we saw that the South India revenue growth was more than the non-South regions, especially because Kalyan as a brand, we have showrooms in all tier 1, tier 2, tier 3 markets in Correct. South. So when a customer is not working in the metro and has moved to their native in South India, we will be able to cater them as well, because we have stores in tier 3, tier 4 cities here.
Mm-hmm.
But outside South India, we are there only in the metros and tier 1 cities. So if a person temporarily, he relocates himself or herself to a small town, we will not be able to cater them because our stores are not there in those areas.
Correct.
But when you look at June, the South and non-South revenue growth is almost similar. We think that people have gone back to their own places now, and that is being visible in our South non-South growth when it comes to June.
Right. And overall, Ramesh, do you think FY22 we will be able to come back to pre-COVID levels?
So if you look at now, the July August momentum is very similar to Q4, wherein, you know, Q4 we had a huge revenue growth, and the momentum is almost similar. And there is a huge shift which is there from the unorganized to organized. The hallmarking again coming in action is again going to drive more unorganized customers to the organized segment. So there is no reason, immediate reason, to not to go, meaning not to change anything from the present momentum which we have. So this year the momentum is really good, and the comeback is also very quick.
Right. And very lastly, Ramesh, with regards to how the gold prices are panning out, are you seeing a trend right now where, you know, we do see a slump when the prices are touching the roof, and when you see some bit of a correction that comes in, that's when customers are actually coming to buy?
No, so it depends upon customer to customer. Certain customer postpone their purchase when the gold prices are very high. Certain customers prepone their purchase because they think that the price will go further high. Same happens when it comes to when the price is decreasing as well. So some customers will wait for the price to come down further. Certain customers will come quickly because they want to kind of get or buy in this low price.
Right.
So price movement is a very common scenario in our segment, and people have also witnessed that. And everyone knows that jewelry is one of the most liquid assets which a person can own, and on a long term they have only seen this asset appreciating. And especially in COVID times, we even see youngsters now walking into the stores because of maybe the asset value for this what you call material.
Right. All right, Ramesh, thank you so much for sharing your insights. Always a pleasure to speak to you.
Thank you.
Good luck. Congratulations once again, and speak to you soon again, and stay safe.
Sure. Thank you.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel for in-depth interviews of India Inc. and press the bell icon so that you do not miss our updates.